Thank you. Hi, everyone. Welcome. The title of my talk today is Take Me to Your Leader, Let's Learn to Love, Understand, and Live with Insects. So yes, I'm going to talk about bugs. And talking about bugs in front of a mixed audience is occasionally kind of risky because a lot of people don't like bugs. And I get this. They're wiggly, they move pretty erratically, and you never really know which are the bugs that are going to bite, right? Yeah. Just say the word earwig. Huh? At a party? Yeah, and people involuntarily shudder. And I know this, and I know this really, really well, because I'm an entomologist. And specifically, I'm a forest entomologist. And so this is actually manifest in my very own family, because sadly, my 9-year-old daughter really hates bugs. If there's a beetle in the basement, that kid pounds her way up the stairs to come get mom to remove that thing and get it out of any possible contact with her body in any way. Now, I haven't told her yet, but part of mom's job is to let people know that, yeah, the forests in BC are actually crawling with insects. Let's take this example here. This is one of my favorite bugs, and you can see there's a weevil, if you look really carefully, right in the middle of that slide. This is actually a tree-killing insect, and when I took this picture, I had very rudely taken the bark off of this tree, and this is this weevil, right moments after I've peeled off the bark from his very cozy home, blinking in the sunlight, looking at the world beyond, and thinking, weevil overcome! Ah, I know. You can't get it to be an entomologist without at least a couple of weevil puns in your back pocket. But the point is, there's a lot of insects out there, and they're doing a lot of different things. So the question always comes up, okay, Jeannie, I kind of think I knew that there was insects out there in the forest, I got that. But, you know, how many of them are there, and should we be worried? Are they all weevil? I mean, evil? Yeah. Let's start with a human-centered view of what insects look like and when we notice them in our forest ecosystems. If you look really carefully at this picture, I took it at a campsite in northern British Columbia across a beautiful Canadian lake, and you can see, if you look carefully, that there's actually a lot of gray trees in this stand. And the reason that there's gray trees in this stand and it starts to attract human attention is a little beetle called a spruce beetle. So spruce beetle is actually related a little bit distantly to that weevil I just showed you, but it's also a tree killer. And it's one that actually has been doing quite a bit of damage in BC. Just this year, we mapped just over 500,000 hectares of damage due to spruce beetle, so what looks like in the stand here. The year before, it was just over 370,000 hectares. So that's a lot of area that's being essentially damaged or trees that are being killed by this tiny little insect. So here's the culprit here. This is a spruce beetle, one of my favorite also insects. It's very cute, tiny, about the size of a grain of rice. And although we actually know quite a bit about spruce beetles, there's still a lot that we need to understand about these little creatures in order to live with them well. So one of the things that I've been working on of late, one of the projects that I've been working on, one of the offshoots of that particular project was that we now have a spruce beetle genome. So now that we have a spruce beetle genome, it allows somebody like me to look at those genome sequences and I can actually devise what I've been calling a genetic signal. If the insect ingests this genetic signal, we can actually silence or turn off selective genes inside their little bodies. That sounds really cool, right? Well, the real power of this particular ability and this new technique that we're developing actually only comes into play when we combine it with an older tool for managing spruce beetle. So here's the older tool, doesn't look super fancy, but this is what's known as a trap tree. A trap tree is basically just a tree that we cut down, it falls over, and spruce beetle actually find this irresistible. So spruce beetle tend to live most of the time, before we notice them as humans, in dead, dying, and downed trees. So a trap tree sort of acts as a sponge to soak up excess beetles in an area. But the key thing to remember about trap trees is that if you don't take them out of the location where you've dropped them, the beetles will happily reproduce in them and move onto the surrounding standing healthy trees. So if we put trap trees down, they work to soak up beetles. If we don't take them out, they can actually make the problem worse. So my idea is that we actually take this genetic signal, put it inside the trap tree by axe frilling around the base. It's translocated up through the tree. We cut down the tree, it acts as a sponge to soak up excess beetles in a particular area that we're concerned about, and what you end up with, essentially, is a trap tree full of dead beetles. that can be left in place to decompose naturally where you originally felled it. So here's me and a weevil hugging it out, and I thought that this was a nice slide to end on because I think it really brings home the message that if you can't, in all honesty, love insects, hopefully an increased understanding of these insects and their biology will help us to live well with them in forest ecosystems. And that, of course, is what I'm going to keep working on my daughter for as well, for that beetle in the basement. She can't live with it. At least we can maybe live well with it in the backyard, not in the basement. Thank you very much. Thank you.